Yeah, ideally you should only test what changed. The problem is that many code bases is like this. If you change a module, you're afraid the other thing broke. Thus, you're always running all the tests all the time. But if you created a good separation in your modules in a way that you can change them independently without breaking each other, then, and you have the confidence, you can start just testing what changed. Now, if they are separated already in different modules, like physically in a different repository, every time you push to a different repository, you only run the test for that repository. But if they are in the same repository, like a monorepo, you have many modules in the same repository, then you don't get this for free. Xcode doesn't do that for you. But what you can do is you can create your own custom script that will check the git diff, and then you can see all the files that changed. And depending on your project structure, by the file hierarchy, depending on the folder where the file is in, you can infer which module it's in. So very simply, you can get parse the git diff, what files changed, and get their folders, infer the module, and only run the test with Xcode build. And you run Xcode build test, and you pass exactly the scheme for that module, and you only run tests on that module. And you can speed up a lot your tests and still have a monorepo. You don't need to separate in different repositories. But you need to create this script. Okay. Shouldn't be hard. It's a good exercise.